Doctors Without Borders, Médecins Sans Frontières, we have three general areas where we have been traditionally providing emergency care with infrastructures established to set up and provide for emergency services. All of those three centers have been severely affected in the earthquake, and none of them are in a condition that we can use. One has completely collapsed. Two others are so structurally damaged we cannot use them. As a result, in all three locations, we've established a temporary shelter and moved our operations outside of those referral hospital settings. The challenge then for the team is the level of care we can now provide without that infrastructure is very limited. So where we're focusing our energy is on the rapid influx of patients from the neighborhoods who know of our services. The best we can offer them at the moment is first aid care and stabilization. The reality of what we're seeing is severe traumas, head wounds, crushed limbs, severe problems that cannot be dealt with the level of medical care that we currently have available with no infrastructure really to support it. So our major priority and focus is to reestablish as soon as possible a secondary level surgical capacity in the country. That I think gives a general snapshot of where we currently are. We have altogether around 800 staff, medical staff, working in Haiti. 30 of those are international. We're currently putting rapid response plans into place based out of North America and out of Europe to have another 70 international staff available over the next few days with specialities available to respond to these more immediate emergency medical needs. Likewise, we're prepared to and have now prepared freight, including emergency inflatable hospital, so we can set up exactly those services that we're currently missing. Teams are basically managing what comes to them. There's very little possibility to get out and do more than that at the moment. Already teams are getting overwhelmed. Even our coordination offices, we're strongly identified in Haiti with emergency medical care. Even our coordination offices are becoming centers of influx for people in neighborhoods with severe trauma wounds. So even in our capital offices where we're trying to maintain contact with our teams, they're struggling to manage a quite high caseload of patients seeking medical care. So it's a very chaotic situation. Communications, as you know, are down in terms of mobile systems. Information for us is very difficult to gather. It's very difficult to be aware of exactly what our teams are up to, where, and how things generally progress. So there are many constraints to being able to provide accurate information to you at the moment. You've got to bear in mind that we only had an hour of daylight last night. The teams have been working all night. And we're still trying to catch up with what the teams have been able to find out since we had the advantage of daylight this morning. Again, reports from our teams of actually trying to get out this morning. People were sleeping on all the roads where we would have liked to be able to move last night, the roads that are not completely obstructed with rubble. Massive destruction, including much of MSF's infrastructure also. And everywhere we go, a massive demand from people to help them with trapped family members, with people who are suffering from major injuries. So you know, you're on the streets, you're getting mobbed, particularly because we're identified with that kind of medical care. So we have not accounted for all of our staff. We're very concerned about the welfare and safety of our staff, both international and national. So we have not accounted for all of our staff, and we're making every effort to do so. We're in direct contact with all of the family who have family members working with Médecins Sans Frontières, Doctors Without Borders in Haiti. And out of respect to them, and with the gaps in information that we currently have, I don't really have any more details that I can share. But this is a major focus, a major priority for the organization. Likewise, for our national team members, many of them were involved, were working in structures that fell apart during the earthquake. Many have families who live in very precarious conditions anyway in Port-au-Prince. So a major concern for them is what has happened to their families. So they're also trying to establish that in addition to supporting the emergency care of the organization. So that is for us one of the key pillars that we're trying to work on right now, and I don't have all the information yet to brief you more thoroughly.